Nå er statsminister. Du må være med. Du statsminister.
En venn var her.
Dear Prime Ministers, dear General Secretary, ladies and gentlemen, this is a really unique forum to discuss so openly and really fact-driven the challenges that we're facing. First, how globally competitive is the Nordic region in the aftermath of the crisis? Where do we stand? What are the fundamentals? What does that mean for action priorities? And where can we as a Nordic region really make headway by collaborating?
We are leading on the green technology. And just looking at the water resources, for instance, and the waste disposal, how do we handle waste? How do we handle clean water? That technology is, well, daily life for us in the Nordic countries. But for a huge country like China, it's only starting. And the worries about such a big population, using so much water, producing so much waste, that's a huge market potential for Nordic companies.
Well, I think we have very similar economies, and we are in the forefront globally on using cap and trade, using steering mechanisms inside the economy for green growth. And we can learn from each other, and we can sometimes also take examples from each other, and we can be active together inside international bodies to push for a more climate-proof direction.
We have a lot of renewable energy, and we can produce more of renewable energy. We are able to work for efficiency in our our energy consumption, and there was a great interest to continue to do that. I think we can do a lot in our transportation system. We can do a lot in our electricity systems.
The interesting thing is that other countries, for example, Europe, I mean, we look at the Commission, they look at us as a unified region and say, why don't you come together and take the lead in some different parts, not in many in many areas, but in some. And also China and India say the same. Why don't you come together? Why are you? Well, now we meet Norway, now we meet Iceland, but you could be a lot stronger together.
You can do more for the education system. You can offer Asian students to come to the Nordic countries. Nordic students can go to the Asian countries. We're already doing that, but we're not doing it as much as we should. If you do that, you automatically get access to a larger pool of talents, and you will have to focus or restructure the education system so that it trains the students for the jobs of the future.
There is much more to be done on education. I think we need a stronger strategy to think about how the high demands that we put on our companies in terms of environmentally friendly products and services become also European and global standards, because that's the only way that we really can become an important test market. So there's lots to do. The more crucial point probably is to, you know, let's pick the two or three things that we decide we really want to make headway on, stop talking, and really move to action.